Hello, good to have you here. I'm Ken Carothi. I'm pastor at Desert Hope, and great to have you here this morning. It's morning for me. You may be watching it later, but we just wanted to say I feel like Ed McMahon this morning. Ed McMahon, do you remember Ed McMahon? I think most of you do. People from our church, we're all a little older. We remember Ed McMahon. He was a sidekick to Johnny Carson. Johnny Carson was the late night host for many years, beloved and funny guy, of course. And his sidekick was Ed McMahon. And Ed McMahon would come on every show. And he would have a mic, and before Johnny came out with these huge curtains that he'd come out between the curtains and give his little talk, he would say, "Here's Johnny." And then Johnny would come out to some music and so forth. I feel like Ed McMahon today. I feel like Ed McMahon, and we all are Ed McMahons. We point to somebody else. We point to somebody else, and it's Jesus Christ. We get to say, "Here's Jesus." We say, "Here's Jesus" by looking at our life. Does our life show it? Does our life have integrity? Do we have faith and trust and excitement about knowing the Lord Jesus Christ? We get to say, "Here's Johnny" to a world waiting for somebody to save them, to give them hope, to give them a chance to have a rock in this world that is so precarious. So I feel like Ed McMahon today saying, "Here's Johnny." We point to Jesus. Remember John the Baptist? Johnny, different John. John the Baptist, he said, "Here's Jesus." And he said that when they came to him, his disciples were worried about Jesus becoming more famous than John the Baptist and those who followed John. Didn't like that. And John the Baptist said a very beautiful thing. He said, "I must decrease, he must increase." John the Baptist was Ed McMahon. John the Baptist pointed to Jesus and he said, "There's the man. I'm nothing. I just make the announcement that Jesus Christ lives." And as a result, we are good. Now, also, Ed McMahon, you may have forgotten this, Ed McMahon was involved with Clearing House Publishing, which, remember, we always got those big, big letters from Clearing House, and in the letter, it would say, "You've won $10 million, but you didn't, but you had a chance of winning $10 million. So Ed McMahon, he got the wonderful, wonderful thing and job of going to people's houses. Remember those pictures of they knock at the door, it's him, it's Ed McMahon along with the video camera team, and the people open the door and they got this huge check there. They won like, you know, $50 million and they start screaming, get so excited about it and so forth. That's us as well. Do you know that you're rich? You and I are rich, stinking rich because of Jesus Christ. Because of the family of faith that we have. We are so rich, greater than if we won the lottery. Ephesians 1 tells us how rich we are. "Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in the heavenly realms," that's the spiritual realms, in spiritual things, "with every spiritual blessing in Christ. He chose us before the creation of the world. He predestined us to be adopted as his children through Jesus Christ, in accordance with his good pleasure, to the praise of his glorious grace, which he has freely given us in the one he loves. In him we have redemption through his blood, forgiveness of sins in accordance with the riches of God's grace that he lavished on us." Verse 11, "In him we were also chosen, having been predestined according to the plan of him who works everything out according to his purpose." Anyway, that's how rich you are. You're redeemed. You've been adopted by Christ. You've been chosen. You've been blessed. You've received his love. You have the forgiveness of sins. Go to Ephesians 1 if you want to look at your lottery ticket and see how rich you really are, how rich we are. We are so rich. Why do we walk around like we're paupers? Why do we walk around like, you know, we aren't the richest people in the world? When that happens, when we begin to understand the riches we have, I think then we will move in the direction of becoming very, very excited about this Christian walk and knowing him. I'm going to start a series on the Gospel of John starting tomorrow. And also I noticed that some folks back up in Milbank are watching. Mary Hepper, I know, want to thank you for coming this morning. We miss you guys. And also all of you others who are watching. Tomorrow I start John. John is a beautiful book. I love John. Anyway, I want to pray and then give a benediction. Lord Jesus, we thank you for how rich we are. May we know how rich we are. Come to know how rich we are. May your Spirit give us the ability to know and comprehend the deepest riches of your love. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. And my benediction is simply to make Christ known and make him known. Share the riches. Amen. Ciao.